உள்கடக்கும் விஞ்ஞானம் ஓதுவது சத்யயுகம், சொல் கடக்கும் பொருளும் ஸ்தாபிப்பு. நானற்ற, மனமற்ற, பிரபஞ்சமற்ற, ஆழ்ந்த உறக்க அனுபவம் எந்த தனி மனிதருடைய தத்துவ ஆராய்ச்சியும் அல்ல. அதுவே தமிழ்நாட்டில் காலங்காலமாக ஆன்மீகம், லௌகீகம் என்று பிரிக்கப்படாது உபதேசிக்கப்படுகின்ற ஒவ்வொரு தனி மனிதனும் தினம் அனுபவிக்கும் உள்கடந்த முடிந்த கடவுள் அனுபவம், முடிந்த ஞான அனுபவம். அவ்வளவே. அருணாச்சல ரமணன் குரல் ஒன்று ஆன்ம விஞ்ஞானம், அகக்குரல் திரட்டு, அதிகாரம் சத்யயுகம் ஸ்தாபிப்பு. லீடு 20, லீடு 20, மரணமில்லா பெருவாழ்வு கலை, த ஆர்ட் ஆஃப் டெத்லெஸ் எட்டர்னல் லிவிங். 20, எக்ஸ்பிளனேஷன் 20. திஸ் இஸ் எ க்வெஸ்சன் தட் ஹாஸ் பீன் சென்ட் ஆர் ரெவலேஷன்ஸ் தட் ஹாஸ் டேக்கன் பிளேஸ் இன் ஸ்ரீமதி சரஸ்வதி விஸ்வநாதன், தஞ்சாவூர். ஷீ ஹஸ் சென்ட் திஸ் டெக்ஸ்ட் மெசேஜ். This has been a revelation that has taken place in her. You will find it in the slide. Namaskaram Swamiji, just a new revelation has occurred. The sense of separate self is due to the incapability of the mind to understand the presence. And rightly, the mind is termed as an upadhi in the Advaitic tradition. See, she is starting this first revelation as the sense of separate self. It never entertains a separateness at all in the first place. It alone is. The sense of separate self, she in the process of reflecting within herself, she has got this revelation as a sense of separate self is due to the incapability of the mind. There is nothing at all called as mind existing anywhere in this cosmos. This is what the deepest realization is. At any point in our waking state life, at any moment during our waking state life, we don't feel the presence of a thought or a feeling to support a false structure. Innately, there doesn't exist a separateness at all called as a thought. See, whatever you think, does a separate feeling as I, does it exist? Does it exist in your thought? Thoughts come and go. But unless and until you realize this truth, that thoughts do not carry a separate I feeling in it, in them, the feelings also do not arise out of a separate entity called as an I, that settles everything, that settles the fake mirage like mind's existence. There is nothing called as a mind, a sense of separate self, that is what is called as mind. In the very first place, it doesn't exist. Okay. So, this is what the first statement is. The next statement comes, and rightly the mind is termed as an upadhi. Upadhi means form. Form. That which has dimension. A form. A shape. the science is itself has now established that in the tiniest speck of even beyond atom, the quantum dynamics has found that still beyond all these particles, beneath the particles, there exists creation. Something goes on doing something, creating something or the other. But the doer could not be found. The actor could not be found in the creation. Science itself has established this. So, wherever you see a dimension, all your thoughts are dimensional. All your feelings are dimensional. It is created, constantly being created during our waking states and as our dream states by a fake self-centrical entity, which itself is a fake. That is why even if you get a wildest dream, you are coming out of it because immediately the waking state barges in, and because of fear, suddenly the whole body is awakened. It is woken up. The body is woken up. And you come out of fear of the dream also. You are driven out of the fear of the dream by the intrusion of the waking state. When are we going to get the real awakening? What is that real awakening? In this waking state itself, in this very waking state, where one is constantly engaged, entangled oneself in thinking, thoughts and feelings, there is no center at all in any of the thoughts, any of the feeling. This has to be realized right now, here. How? Just look at it. Who looks at it? Imply the same thought itself as the onlooker without really keeping an onlooker in that observation. Just look at it. Thought vanishes. That thought goes away. Feeling goes away. They fall flat. Reality need not arise by way of our thinking. Okay. Even these reflections, even these revelations, look at it, still go beyond them. You said, rightly, the mind is termed as upadhi. Yeah, because it has a dimension. What is the mind? It's nothing but thoughts, feelings, conglomeration. If one doesn't look within, this exists continuously, because it is on a cosmological level, universal level, this is operating. Because universe itself exists as that only. It doesn't have a separate existence also, which this universe, this cosmos, doesn't have a separate existence. So that has to be constantly it has to be felt as the reality, not through thoughts, not through understanding, not through taking a particular angle, perspective and looking at it. See, our Vedanta itself says, not even upadhi. For the upadhis to come into operation, there exist three gunas. Three gunas. Three gunas actually, in the presence of that, three gunas manifest themselves as this cosmos. The moment I say cosmos, you are also included, I am also included. But we only will have to turn within ourselves and look at what is the source of all these things, because that is the only way given here, not through any other methods. Okay, so we have clarified the first para of your question. Then comes that the presence is beyond the mind, beyond time, beyond space, beyond objects. That is obvious during our deep sleep state. The transcendence itself is called as godliness in Tamil. Kada ul, ul kada. They are all fictional, not real. Even to say real or unreal, it is that is why beautifully they say anirvachaniyam. You cannot put a word for these happenings, for the existence of the mind, for the existence of the thought, for the existence of a feeling, separate feeling. What they say? Anirvachaniyam. Vachaniyam means that which is speakable. Speakable. One can say it. One can configure it. One can configure words and communicate with that. This cannot be communicated. That is why they had used the word for mind. What is mind? Anirvachaniyam. What is maya? Anirvachaniyam. What is avidya? Anirvachaniyam. Because there don't exist an objective essence in objects at all, including our physical life. Including our physical lively existence. If I am a biological living being, that being is actually a movement in inertia. In the presence of what? In the presence of the Trigunas. Since this physical organism called as a human being has the capacity that is reflecting within himself as thoughts, feelings, movement, as a separate consciousness, because he is the minuscule reflection of the transcendent reality, that which exists during our deep sleep state. We are minuscule gods, micro level gods, microcosmic gods. But for that God to manifest in us, we should not isolate ourselves through our thoughts or through our feelings. Throughout our waking state, this has to be done. This has to be consciously been going on realized. One cannot let an interval, one cannot allow a gap in this realization process. So, that the presence is beyond the mind, beyond time, beyond space, beyond objects. Yes, it's beyond all this waking state, cosmos as well as the separate mind. Because the cosmos as well as the mind arises out of a fake, registered, recorded entity called as cosmic mind through the this eye. Okay. Then comes the next statement. While the mind can interpret only in the language of cause and effect, subject-object duality, and so gives us the interpretation that the body with senses with which the mind works is here, and that something seen outside the perimeter of the body. Again, who is the seer? Subject and object, cause and effect. These don't exist during our deep sleep state. This is our state. Royally, we can claim. One can have this with concrete privilege, right, claim. Surupa is our reality. The reality of everything is the reality of this spatial spatio-temporal reality, also called as mind. So that we can achieve. There is no achiever. An achieverless achievement is achieved. Finally, if one realizes this fact, he is neither an achiever nor a failure. So, outside the perimeter of the body is separate from matter. Something seen outside the perimeter of the body, again, don't get into probabilities. There is no seer from outside of it. It never lets an outsider or something to look at it from outside. There is no perimeter at all. It is immensity itself. Immensity itself, it is already inclusive of everything. All inclusiveness is singularity, truth. Even if one claims that he has not realized, in his non-realization is also materializing within himself by its presence only. If I say, I have not known, I have not realized that, my ignorance or my nescience also is affirmed, confirmed only by the existence of that. So there is neither atheist nor atheist. It never leaves duality at all. There never exists duality at all. This is a kind of it alone is. Then, thus perpetuating a false personhood with memory and vasanas to its aid. You say that perpetuating, it never does any action. It doesn't even know that there exists something as false, because in truth, only truth is. Even in false, only truth is. Even in ignorance, even in nescience, only truth is. Even if you claim that I have not yet realized, I am yet to realize, there is no I am-ness is left with to realize at all, at any point in time or space. So there exists nothing apart from it, away from it. It alone is. You see all these vasanas to it, said, yes. See, what to say? When a realized soul wants to communicate this, somewhere he has to start. But in the end, when it is shown properly by a realized person, the person who is communicated with the truth also comes to that knowledge, comes to that understanding, wisdom. Yes, I was never ever bound at all in the first place to get realized or to get salvation or to get liberated. Okay. Then, while the presence is totally unconcerned or oblivious to the experiences of the false self, oblivious to the experiences of the false self, as from the standpoint of presence, nothing exists other than itself, and it alone knows itself. See, it is not the way of the truth. Only the false has to keep an identity, to run it. It is what is called as avidya. What they say, beautiful word is used. Avidya. What is avidya? One has enclosed himself. One has covered himself. One has closed oneself. This is what is avidya. even in that enclosure, even that enclosure itself is revealed to him only through that. So one is never bound at all. One is never ignorant at all. One is never a nascent being at all. So this truth, this truth of the reality, the truth of the deep sleep state does not concern or become unconcerned or oblivious, because it alone is, as you said at the end of that, it alone knows itself. It alone, even not knowing, knowingness is its nature. We cannot even put the word knowledge. Knowledge means again a stagnatory thing. This has to be clearly seen through. Attamalakam. Amalakam. Amalakam means idu nelika. Adapola ullangai nelikani idu truth. அது சத்வகுணம் வந்து புத்தியில் அப்படியே தாண்டவம் பாடும். ஒன்ஸ் த இன்டெலக்ட் இஸ் பியூரிஃபைட், யூ கெட் பிஹைண்ட், யூ கோ டு த ரூட் ஆஃப் ஆல் தீஸ் ரெவலேஷன்ஸ் ஆல்சோ, ஹூ இஸ் த ரியலைசர் அகெய்ன், ஓகே. தென் கம்ஸ் த நோயிங் ஆஃப் ஆல் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்சஸ் இஸ் இன் த பிரசன்ஸ் அலோன் அண்ட் நாட் இன் த பாடி மைண்ட். எஸ் அப்சல்யூட்லி ரைட். The knowing of all experience, it alone eats through you, it alone walks through you, it alone thinks through you, it alone is frustrated through you, it alone enjoys through you. All emotions, all feelings, all physical movements, all physical cosmos, psychological trikunas, sattva, rajasa, tamasa guna, everything is its food. It is tasting everything through these trigunas. And these three gunas with the cosmos, with individuals, do not exist away from it or apart from it. Okay. So all experiences are taking place for that, in that, by that, and it alone is the bhokta. Bhokta means the enjoyer, the supreme enjoyer. That is why we will have to simply denounce, drop a moment, a feeling of past has arisen in us, that on such and such day it was a beautiful moment or it was a frustrating moment, whatever be that, it cannot exist as such unless that is existing throughout timelessly. In every individual mind also. Okay. Then finally you said, please correct me Swamiji if wrongly understood. No. Everything is a part and parcel of that happening. It's a beautiful happening. Beautiful flowering in you. And through you, the world also benefits. So it's a beautiful revelation that has taken place in you. It has shed more deeper perspectives in me too. So it's a beautiful, beautifully happened thing. Thank you for reading it patiently. No, we have taken a satsang out of this, and this is going to be the 20th lead. For the 20th lead, we are going to use this. I will take this in Tamil also for the benefit of all. So what one has to do out of this is simply drop whatever the identity you have over your passing thought or a passing emotion, feeling. There is no center at all. Everything is enjoyed only by that. What we mean directly, we pinpoint the deep sleep state. Deep sleep state is the blemishless, beginningless, middleless, endless, magnificent, immense intelligence, easiness, and true feelings of consciousness. Okay? This is what one has to do. Don't perch on to your thoughts by continuing its memory. Don't give continuity or conformity to your passing I feelings. Allow, let go, be let go. Be always dwell in a let go mood of feelings as well as thoughts. This is what is going to be the practice of Lead 20. We will take this same question in Tamil too and we will explain it.